Are you listening? This is a story about fear. The fear of losing someone you love. A story about a secret forever hidden in darkness. But most of all, this is a story about someone brave. Someone who sacrificed it all for what she loved. This is a story about my mother.
Sweets before bedtime.
Well, we're not allowed to play music this late either.
Suit yourself then. You were snoring last night.
Will you ever stop teasing me? Mom's coming!
Alice, turn off the gramophone.
Don't tell me you broke it this time.
Oh, well done, Alice.
You, young lady, should have been in bed an hour ago. When I come back, you better be asleep. Jane's medicine is really working this time.
I'm glad to hear that. We have to make sure she's really careful with it, though. Many things can go wrong if it's not the correct dose. A whole bottle could kill a grown-up man.
You know I appreciate that you're always taking care of this family.
Well, there must be some reason why you love me. It's time to wake up now. I think you've overslept again.
It could be because I had such a wonderful dream.
The girls are waiting, honey.
Mm-mm. I'll stay here.
But then, who's gonna make breakfast?
Someone blonde and tall.
You think I should do it?
Why not? I think it's about time.
I don't believe that's a job for a man.
I'll do it myself, then.
Do you need any help?
Yes, you can go and get your brother.
Okay, Mom. I'll be back soon, then.
Good morning, Mom.
Did you sleep well last night?
I did.
I assume your medicine is working, then.
Can I help you?
No, it's okay, Wendy dear.
Very well, then. And Alice is late as usual.
Hogarth wasn't in his room, Mom. He could have went somewhere else.
That's nonsense. He would never go anywhere without asking for permission. He's in big trouble.
Good evening, ma'am. My name is Kent Mansley. I'm from the police. So when was the last time you saw Hogarth?
Last night. He was asleep. He would never go anywhere without telling us.
Who's the medicine for?
It's for Jane. She has trouble sleeping.
I just want to ask the rest of your family a few questions before I go. And don't worry. I will find out what happened to your son.
Where are you, Hogarth?
Mom, I know we'll find him. He'll come back to us. I just know that.
Shouldn't you be in bed?
How could I possibly sleep when I know Hogarth is not here?
You're only making everything worse. Go to sleep.
Cindy, you don't have to take this out on the children.
Can't you see someone is after our family, John? You're not even worried, and I'm a wreck! Don't you have any feelings at all? I just want my son back again.
Will you stop arguing?
You're tearing apart everything we have got left.
Jane, dear? Oh, honey, don't worry. It was just a nightmare.
Mom.
What is it?
Forget it.
You know something, don't you?
No, I don't.
If you know something, you must tell me. Jane, talk to me. You know something. What is it?
What's going on? Why are you crying, Jane?
Maybe I shouldn't have gone this far. I don't know where I am. Is anyone home? Oh, wrong house.
Wait a minute. Good evening. I think you better come with me to my office, ma'am. Is it possible that you may have forgotten to tell me certain things? That's right. I've finally finished this puzzle, and I know everything. It all begins with your now dead husband, John. I found your son, Hogarth's camera, outside your house. Hogarth apparently took photos to prove what your husband had done to little Jane all those years. John had to do something about Hogarth. You didn't know anything about the sexual abuse until last night.
Oh, honey, don't worry. It was just a nightmare.
And that's when we come to the murder part. You were cooking food for your husband.
A whole bottle could kill a grown-up man.
Tell me, was it hard to act surprised in front of your little Wendy? Your daughter finally realized what she had done and got scared. So she ran away and left you, knowing you had not only lost one child. And now, of course, you're wondering how I could know all this. I must say, your daughter wasn't that difficult to break. You killed your husband.
Do you have children, sir?
No, I don't.
Then you cannot judge me. I did what had to be done to protect my children.
You're right. I can't judge you. That's up to the court. I hope you have God on your side.
I was judged for accessory to murder and had to spend 15 years in prison. My siblings were taken to an orphanage. They were the first people I met when I got there. My mother was judged for third-degree murder, and a lifetime in prison now awaited her. She was taken to a woman's prison on an island far away. I never saw her again.
I was 5 and he was 6. We rode on horses made of sticks. He wore black and I wore white. He would always win the fight. Bang, bang, he shot me down. Bang, bang, I hit the ground. Bang, bang, that awful sound. Bang, bang, my baby shot me down. Seasons came and changed the time. When I grew up, I called him mine. He would always laugh and say, remember when we used to play? Bang, bang, I shot you down. Bang, bang, you hit the ground. Bang, bang, that awful sound. Bang, bang, I used to shoot you down. Music played and people sang. Just for me, the church bells rang. He's gone, I don't know why. Until this day, sometimes I cry. He didn't even say goodbye. He didn't take the time to lie. Bang, bang, he shot me down. Bang, bang, I hit the ground. Bang, bang, that awful sound. Bang, bang, my baby shot me down.